Hi there, it's Sam here from Kipo Art Studio. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you a simple compositing technique in Photoshop. So I'll make a composite of two images by matching the ambient color and the brightness as well. This is the background image. This is the woman's photo before background removal. This is how it looks after refreshing the background, but before matching its ambient color and brightness with the background image. And this is the final result after blending both images using a simple compositing technique using Photoshop. Alright, let's jump right into the tutorial. In this demonstration, I'm using Photoshop CC 2021. Firstly, open the background image with Photoshop. You might want to unlock the background layer. Then drag the woman photo onto the canvas. And if you want to resize it, press the Alt key on your keyboard to maintain its aspect ratio. Now let's remove the background from the woman's photo. Select the woman layer, go to select and mask. If you use Photoshop CC 2021, you can click the Select Subject button right away and wait for the Photoshop's artificial intelligence to analyze and make a selection over the woman pixels. In this example, the automatic select subject feature works pretty good, so I don't need to correct the subject selection. Then tick the Recontaminate Color checkbox to remove the background colors left over around the hair. Select Output to New Layer with Layer Mask and click OK. Now the background image has been replaced. Move the subject to wherever you want. If you see there's a background color left over like this, select the layer mask, make a selection around the leftover using the lasso tool or polygonal lasso tool. Go to Edit, Fill, and at the Contents drop-down, select Black. Now you can delete the previous subject image layer. Here I rename the background image layer as background, and the woman image as main subject. Then we are going to check the ambient color difference between these two images. To do so, add a solid color adjustment layer and give it 50% gray. Make sure the gray layer is selected and change the blending mode to luminosity. Now you can see the difference in the ambient color intensity between the two images. If in your case the color difference is not clear, add a hue saturation adjustment layer and increase the saturation amount until you see a clear picture of ambient color difference. Now we are going to match the ambient color of both woman and background images. Firstly, highlight the hue saturation and color fill layers by pressing the Shift key while clicking on them. Click this folder icon to group them and rename the group as Ambient Color Check. Now, notice any color you want to match. For example, you want to match around the brown color, like the skin color. Then turn off the Ambient Color Check layer for a while. And notice the area of any brown color from the background image that closely similar with the woman's skin color. Then activate the Ambient Color Check again. And make sure the woman layer is selected. Then add a selective color adjustment layer. Then click this icon to make it as a clipping mask for the woman layer, so it will affect the woman layer only. Now at the properties panel, make sure you select the color you want to match. Here I go with the red first and play with the gauges until the reds of the woman's ambient color match the reds of the background's ambient color. Now I'm going to match the whites. So I select whites at the colors drop-down and play with the gauges again. Make sure they are the same so the composite will look realistic. Now I'm going to match the blacks. Like that. When I turn off the ambient color check, the composite now looks more realistic. So what is left now is the brightness difference between the two images. We are going to match them using a curves adjustment layer. Now make sure the selective color adjustment layer is selected, so that when you add a curves adjustment layer, it will be placed on the top of it. Click this icon again to make the curves become the second clipping mask for the woman image. Then make sure the curves layer icon is selected. Press and hold the Alt key on your keyboard, and at the properties panel, click Auto. Check the Fine, Dark and Light colors, and make sure the Snap Natural Midtones checkbox is unchecked. Then open the Shadows color picker, and choose the darkest color from the background image. Open the Midtones color picker, and choose the midtone color from the background image, which is gray. However, it's not always gray, depending on what midtone color you see in your background image. And for the highlights, pick the brightest color from your background image, but avoid picking a pure white point. Don't worry if you see your main subject become dimmer like this, we can fix them later. When all colors have been set, click OK. As you can see, the brightness and contrast of the two images are now the same. So here I name the selective color adjustment layer as the ambient color matching. And the curves adjustment layer as brightness and contrast matching. Now we are going to match the color brightness by sliding some points on the axis. In this example, I slide the upper axis point a bit to the left to bring up the highlights, the lower axis point slightly up to reduce the shadow's intensity, and slide the midpoint down a bit to reduce the midtone's brightness. Take your time to play with this axis until the brightness and contrast of the two images are the same. And this is the final result. That's how to make a composite image look more realistic in Photoshop. So this is before color matching, and this is after color matching. Alright, that's all for this tutorial. If you like this video, hit the like button, and if you want more tutorials like this, hit the subscribe button for more future uploads. Thanks for watching this video, and see you next time.